The kind of person who should apply for a PhD is someone who's got curiosity, but who's also got stamina. It's a three-year project usually, and it requires a lot of dedication.
Obviously, there needs to be some level of academic credentials, so you'd usually require the equivalent of a first-class honours or 2-1 honours.
You've got to have a passion for study, for independent work, and you've got to have motivation.
If you don't have research training, we do have quite a number of research training opportunities available here, including research methods, masters, which you might take up prior to doing your PhD.
It's really important that you find a potential supervisor who has expertise in your area of interest.
Look at some of the key institutions in the field that you want to work with and see within that list who is doing research related to your field.
Look around, find a good person, and then try and make contact with them so that they will already be involved in the idea of your proposal as it develops. At the University of Kent, you will only be supervised by someone who is actively researching. We have research teams, so you might have a practitioner perhaps who's one of the supervisory team, but essentially the person who is guiding you and helping you is someone who is also working at the forefront of their discipline.
Some subjects require a research proposal, but as a scientist, if people are applying for PhDs to my department, School of Biosciences, a research proposal is not usually required because usually research funding is allocated towards specific projects. So what people would usually be doing is applying to a specific project for which funding is allocated, and really what applicants then need to do is illustrate their candidacy for that project.
A typical proposal for a PhD in humanities will be anything from 1,000 words perhaps, even up to 2,000 words. But what's important is that you have a bibliography there, that you outline your aims and give a really clear sense of what it is you're going to be doing for 3 years. What is it you're going to be studying? How are you going to go about doing that? And what do you think might come out of it in the end?
What I advise candidates to do, if they do find a project that they're interested in, think about their own background, their educational background, their interests, their motivations.
What is it that has led you to this point? Why do you want to do a PhD? What's your motivation? What's your background and experience? And usually also submit a curriculum vitae, a CV, which tells us a bit more about your kind of experience. Because sometimes you might have professional experience that isn't necessarily directly linked to your research, but it shows that you've got staying power or that you've got diverse interests and you're the kind of person who's going to flourish when doing a PhD.
Without PhD students, the University of Kent wouldn't be able to operate in research terms at the high level that it does. So we value them hugely, and they're so important to the research culture here at the university.
If you're thinking about doing a PhD, then think seriously about it. It's going to take 3 years or more. You're going to be in the library a lot, but it's really an exciting opportunity to explore something in which at the end you'll be an expert.
Doing a PhD certainly changed my life. It gave me the career that I have now. It's given me opportunities that I wouldn't necessarily have expected at the time that I was starting my PhD. It's allowed me to travel, meet new people, experience different cultures, and it allows me, perhaps most importantly, to be doing a job that I absolutely love now.
You'll have been abroad, you'd have been at conferences, you'd have talked and talked and written, and it would have changed you, but for the best. So if you're thinking about it, do it.